How's it going, everyone? This is my new monster, the Honda HSS1332ATD. It has the battery start and everything. I'll show you around after, but this is my first impressions. It's actually worth more than my truck. It's a beast. My Tacoma, not really, but it's a solid machine. I saw the reviews on it. You can see the chute is really tall. You got the height of right here. That is about 22 and a half inches. And you got about 32 inch opening. Pretty beastly. And the chute goes up really, really tall as well. About four and a half feet, depending on how much you put it. Very nice machine though. You can also operate it with a thumb right here. This is, I guess, transport mode, if you wanted to. You can just hold it. A lot easier than my old traps. And then this is, digging mode, if you wanted to go far in. So that's digging mode. I'll probably put side, the auger skid shoes right here, the optional ones, just to protect it better. Another thing you have too, on my 928, the new chute control, that's the new one where it's a U-shape so it doesn't clog as much. Honda saw that it clogs. This is the track model, by the way. And it has the LED light. I can't wait to use this thing. I hope we get like a foot of snow. I probably won't though. I paid $36.99 for it plus tax, so around almost $4,000. I'll walk around with you guys just to show you. So you got tracks. This thing's pretty diesel. And then this kind of disappointed me. There's no fuel gauge here, which is kind of weird. They took that away on the 2022 models. So if you guys are looking at, used Honda snowblowers, that's a good indication. I didn't know that. So they removed the fuel gauge there. Just something to note. And the older HS1332s don't have these shrouds either. See the heat shroud? I already put a battery tender. Let me show you that. So you got right here, I connected it. So I can just plug it into my battery tender if I want to, just keep the battery fresh. A lot of places are price gouging too on this, the Honda 1332, up north where they're getting snow. Down here, we got about six of them and, no issues. But on this, you have the thumb control right here. This actually has a gas strut and you can go really well. Look at that, low down. You wanted to, that's like transport mode or off the grass. I like that a lot. Then you have so this is the gas strut that does that. You have a lot of things. You got the choke here, you got the speed control so you can go fast or slow, very easy to move. Hydrostatic here, you got joystick here, then you got the battery start. We'll try it. I haven't started it yet. Then you have the hour meter. I didn't have that on the 928, so that's new. You got the tracks, like I said. To go back or forward, you just have to hold both triggers. See the triggers? Or if you're steering, see, this is the drive. So this brings you fluid, hydrostatic. This is the hydrostatic right here. But that's the drive. And if you go auger, it'll lock it down in place. That's kind of cool. But these are the triggers. If you bring them both down, you can move it back and forth, which it disengages instead of the old HS1332 where you had to, go down there and put engage or disengage to do it, and it didn't move that well. This moves pretty decent. And the other one had only three positions too on the 1332 or the 1132. This has plenty of different positions. You can just see it. We'll take this off on the hour meter. Let's see here. Brand new. And then so I'm gonna put premium gas into it. Over here you got a lot of electronics and stuff. They did fill the oil, so that's good. You want to make sure it's filled before using. Looks all right. He gave me like a free thing of oil too, gee thanks. But you want to use 5W30 in this tank. And yeah, the deflection's good. Gas cap, when you get it brand new, you get this yellow tag too. That's something to note. But this is just tied on. Just take that off. Get my Leatherman. And hopefully this thing purrs. There we go. Put this to the side. You got a pull start as well if you needed it. So, he does have a little bit of gas in there. But if you need it, you know, to pull start, you have that as well. So that's cool. Kind of fair to try to engage it up. See, it's got to sit right and then it clicks. Cool. So this is the battery. It's all entangled with the battery. It wasn't too bad taking that off either. Then you got skid shoes on here. They already adjusted it. You got to check those once in a while. And you got the dual arching chute control. We'll have to try it out. Another thing, let's see here. Let me lower you guys on the tripod if I can. My girlfriend got me this. Fiance, sorry. There we go. Let's see here. So, on this you have auger detection, which is great because it detects if it's too much strength. There's a wire that actually goes, a cable that goes through here, and it detects if it's too much, strength, or too much shear before shearing these bolts, the shear pins, it's going to detect it and it'll just stop automatically. You'll see a video of some guy, he had like a tree stump and he did it on purpose just to see, but kind of crazy for a $4,000 machine. I don't think I'd do that. I'm pretty happy with the chute design though, just because I had clogging on the 928 a little bit. And so let's see. Got the LED light. This thing's just a monster. It's tall as hell too. I wonder how tall it gets when you do the just for eyes. Damn. About 27 inches. So if you go all the way up, 27 inches. It's cool because you can clean under here too if you needed to. So let's try this out. I'll put gas in it. Kind of excited. It's a beast of a machine, huh? I'm gonna keep a Velcro strap just in case. Fun to have, you know? But let's see here. Yeah, these machines are the ones they keep in, like Vermont or Okemo, where the ski resorts have it. They get incredible snow. It'll be fun just to play around with. I love snow, so. Let me see, okay. So I filled this up with already premium gas and I use StarTron. That's just a thing, a method I've been doing. It's been working great, so. Got some gas. Yeah, there's like nothing in there. Surprised they didn't give me any gas. That price, right? They had the Aaron's Kraken in there too, as well. It was called the Aaron's Kraken. And it was a little over $4,000. That's why I went with this one instead. I love Honda too. The reliability and everything. But Aaron's is good though. As you can see in my other video, I had an Aaron's Deluxe 28 inch show. Really good. I'm just gonna fill like 3/4 of the tank. It doesn't have to be full. That's pretty good. About like a half a tank, that's fine. These last forever too on a tank. Let's hope it starts. It's kind of a pain to click it in, but it works. It's got the, let me see what kind of engine it has. You got the 389cm engine. This thing says it throws 56 feet. So that's pretty cool too. It's just a beast of a machine. We'll see how good it does though in the winter. Hopefully we get like, we usually get like 12 inches, 16 inches sometimes, but last few winters haven't been much. But we'll see. What else is there gonna say? Oh, so I had a Honda 1132. That was my first Honda. This is my fourth Honda, and this is the newest one I've ever had. I had a 1132, which was made in 1999. I flipped that one, and then I bought a Honda 1332, which I had in the videos and stuff. I flipped that one as well for a decent amount, actually tripled the profit, which was incredible. And then I had that 928. So I just wanted the, you know, the biggest, the baddest Honda. There's a 1336 hybrid, but how the hell am I gonna fit that in here? And I could have got like four lawnmowers for this too. It's expensive. It's hydrostatic, it's a commercial unit. They're expensive, but I figured I'd show you guys this. And the wheel, that was the only wheel I had, was the 928. I had a Aaron's Deluxe show before, but I just wanted a track again. They said it has steering and everything. So, let's see how easy it is to start. Put the choke on. Put it fast. Curiosity how tall the chute is when it's just like this. You got about 49 inches tall. It's almost as tall as me. That's crazy. Yeah, it's a bitch. That's cool. Let's try to pull start it just to see. I usually put it in fast. Put it on. snowblowers to get this, a brand new Honda. You get a 3-year warranty with a brand new Honda as well, 1332. I know it's a little cheaper if you went without the battery, but I think that's a must have, having the battery. I think that's an awesome feature, having the battery. What else? I don't think it has a detector, the cheaper one either, where it detects the shear pins. That's another thing. But pretty sweet, guys. I'm enjoying it so far. We'll have to wait for snow just to see how good it does, but it looks like a beast. I'll do a one hurrah around just to see it. Look at that chute. I've never seen a chute so tall. Crazy. But it is a tank. It's got the hour meter, like I said. This just comes off if you wanted to. When you're driving and stuff, I would probably just take that out. Very cool, guys. So 3-year warranty. I'm pumped to get this, and we'll have to test it out. As you can see, there's no snow yet, but this thing will dig right through. All right, thanks, guys, for watching. I'll show you some mods I'll do to this thing, too, before the winter start or the snow starts falling. But all right, thanks, guys, for subscribing. Take care.